I want to open the doors of the church. There's somebody in this room who's been bound by religion but doesn't have a relationship. I want to open up this altar for somebody who's been turned off by church, but you need Christ. I need somebody who's in a crowded room but still feels like you're by yourself. And I want to give you my hand, but I want to give God your heart. If you're here today and you're saying, Pastor, I don't want to live my life bound, tied up. I don't want to be in a chokehold. For real, I feel like I can't breathe. If that's where you are, that's who you are. Would you please come now? Meet me at this altar. Don't worry about people looking at you. All of us had to take this walk. Help me give God some praise for my sister who's coming. Is there somebody else who needs to get saved? She's already broken through. There's room. Help me thank God for this young lady who's coming. I've done my job. I need you to go to work. Ladies and gentlemen, it's not the job of the pastor to catch fish. It's the job of the pastor to clean them. We are fishers of men and of women. If you'll help me, please, let's go fishing. Help me find a soul to add to the body of Christ. Help me to find somebody who will enlarge the territory of this ministry. Everybody move and talk to somebody. And we offer Christ to you. Oh my, if there's somebody else here, would you kindly come? For he will
give you brand new life.
And life.
New life.
If there's somebody else, I need you to come. Oh, come. Come on. To Christ. I'm thankful for the young ladies who are here, but I'm grateful God saves men too. Hallelujah. There's a blessing for some brother. We just got to find where he is. Would you help me, please? If there's a brother near you who you don't know, who you didn't come with, would you go bombard that brother? Tell him his life is on the line. His soul is at stake. Hallelujah. God didn't die for him to be bound. Died so that brother would have life and have it more abundantly. Stretch your right hand of faith towards our dear sisters. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Stretch that right hand of faith. Hallelujah. Here comes somebody else. Would you clap your hands about it? Come on, y'all not clapping good. Don't hate, celebrate. Come on, are y'all gonna help me thank God for this beautiful family? Come on. Bless his name. Stretch your right hand to faith. If there's one more person, we still got time. I don't care how late it is. Your life is worth it. Your life matters. Wherever it is that you are, I need for you to come. Thank you so very much. Stretch that right hand to faith and repeat after me as loud as you can. You are too gifted to be bound. You are officially wrapped. If you believe it, give God a shout even right now. Thank you so much. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. Ladies and gentlemen, if you go further down in that same narrative, there is a striking revelation that I can't afford for you to ignore. The Bible accords to us that there were wise men looking for him. But here's what's amazing, ladies and gentlemen. We have no record of one book they wrote. We have no evidence that they were ever professors at the University of Jerusalem. What made them wise is that they had sense enough to bring a meaningful gift in the presence of the king. Ladies and gentlemen, please don't play the fool. You would not be where you are if it were not for Jesus Christ. Our ambassadors are coming, and they're coming quickly. If you're in need of an envelope, we want to help you. I want you to note, ladies and gentlemen, that the wise men did not give Jesus copper. Didn't give him tin, didn't give him rubber. They gave the highest commodity, gold, silver, gold, frankincense, and myrrh. Ladies and gentlemen, I want you to give your best unto God. I told 7:30 service, something is out of order if you give Macy's more than the master. The Bible says, seek ye first the kingdom of God and thank you. Where's the church? Amen. And all other things will be added unto you. Ladies and gentlemen, whoever it is that you spent the most amount on for Christmas, here's the question, did they die for you? I can't hear nobody. Christmas, here's the news flash, is not about your kids. I can't hear nobody. Christmas is about Jesus Christ. I want you to have a sizable, a significant seed. We all come around for Easter, but there would not be an Easter if there were not a Christmas. I'm going to challenge all of my dear friends. There are thousands of you who are watching online today. Thank you so much. I'm going to challenge you, even if you're en route to your church, I want you to give a seed of $33 on the day. Would you give a seed of $33? That is the years of life that Jesus had on this earth. And I'm believing that God's going to bless you immensely in the first 33 days of the year. I want every person who's a visitor in this colony of faith, if you'll get that seed of 33 in your hand, all of the members of our church, we are a tithing church. We're a tithing church, and because we're a tithing church, we give what percent of our income? I can't hear anybody. What percent? Hallelujah. What percent did God give you? Bless the Lord. God is the giver of every good and every perfect gift. I need you to have that gift in your hand. Every person, would you look at your seed and asking yourself, is this what I give the king? If I give this gift, does this make me wise or foolish? Is this reflective that I know who God is, that I know what he deserves, and I'm mindful of what he's done for me? Now that you have that gift, I need you to stand to your feet, please. I need you to stand. Now that you've stood, I need you to lift up that gift above your head and repeat after me, Lord, wrap my finances so I'm not bound in debt. Use this seed for somebody else's need. In Jesus' name. Amen. Would you turn to your right even now? Thank you. If you'll turn to your right even now, begin coming from the last row. Bless the Lord. Our music ministry is going to lead us. Thank you. Yeah. Everybody is coming. Everybody is sowing. After you would have given, go back to your seats, please. Your neighbor, tell them you matter, you matter.
Black lives matter, girl, yeah.
And don't forget, black lives matter, but so does the life of the gift that God has wrapped for us. Amen. His birthday, Jesus's birthday is coming up, but we want to be a blessing to our pastor. Amen. We know you've already given. We've already sowed. We have one last opportunity. We want you to come back 11:30, but then on this coming Thursday, Christmas service, we want you to sow a seed to be a blessing to Pastor Bryant on his Christmas celebration. Amen. We want to be a blessing to him and his family. So please don't forget, the life of our pastor matters as well. If you're leaving to go out of town, please make sure you have the envelopes with you. Sow that seed. Give it to the ambassadors before you leave. God bless you.
Bless the Lord. Come on, lift up that hand, choir. Lead us right where you are. Black lives matter. Lift up that hand. Everybody shout, Black lives matter. Thank you so much for marching with us on last Sunday. Let me say publicly and take a moment that we absolutely condemn the violent acts against police officers. Two police officers were killed yesterday in New York City. Regrettably, the accused assailant was from Baltimore. I pray that we would, in fact, not just pray for ourselves, but pray for the fearless, noble men and women who sacrifice their lives every day for the police force. Would you help me, do me a favor, celebrate those incredible women and men. Come on, you can do better than that. Bless the Lord. If there are any police officers here, we salute you. We thank God for you. And we pray that God's heavenly covering will surround your life. Lift that hand as high as you can. You may want to stick around. My dear friend and brother is here. Marvin Sapp is here for our 11:30 service. After the year you've had, you just need to hear never would have made it one good time. Amen. So please make sure, as many of you can and will, Christmas morning at 10 a.m. I want to see your face in the place. On New Year's Eve, we'll have two opportunities of worship, 7:30 and 10:30. My new book is out, God's Big Idea Is You. I want you to please get it. It's available in the lobby as soon as service is over. Now, unto him who's able to do anything but fail, may God make you sleepless until you help somebody. May God make you restless until you help yourself. May God irritate you until you have enough sense to worship him. And may God bless you until you have to give stuff away. Henceforth, now, and forevermore, And the blessed people of God said, amen. Your pastor loves you. Have a great day in the Lord, and we'll see you on Christmas morning.
We're counting 1, 2, 3, 4.
No one black guy, no more.
5, 6, 7, 8.
Black people always have been great.
9, 10, 11, 12.
Had too many blacks.
Sin was a crime. What's the chatter? Pump your fist to everybody say.
Looking in the mirror, feeling so much pain. The pills won't work, I still feel the same. Only you can hear my cry. Only you can change my life. Only you. Only you. Because of you,
I surrender to you.
It's because of you,
my soul lifted now.
I can finally breathe again. 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 It wasn't on my own. You gave me back my smile, my peace and my hope. It was you who heard my cry. It was you who changed my life. Only you. I surrender my all to you. Only you. Fix my heart, Lord. Make me brand new. Hallelujah, I can smile again. 'Cause of you, I can finally breathe again. I can finally breathe again. I can finally breathe again. I can finally breathe again.
Test into your testimony, and right here you too can breathe again. Listen.
You can dream again. You can see again. You can breathe.